Allah, the deen of Allah, will prevail. The mu'mineen, they will be victorious with or without us, ya ikhwati fillah. لذلك يقول النبي صلى الله يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى يا أيها النبي أو يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى يقول الله يا أيها النبي حسبك الله ومن اتبعك من المؤمنين. He said, يا أيها النبي, or the prophet of Allah, be concerned with yourself and the who overfellows from the amongst the believers. Because a mu'min, يا إخوتي في الله, gives a nasiha. If the people are not willing to take, then turn your back on them and do what is that which is right. The other thing that you need to know, ya ikhwati fillah, until the day of Qiyamah. And I'm not talking about the innocent people. I'm not talking about this innocent neighbor of yours, a person who's sympathetic with you. I'm not talking about a person who's not involved with this. I'm not talking about a person who is your classmate or your co-worker. I'm talking about these people outside who are trying to fight this deen. They plan day and night. They don't give up. They don't feel, you know, doing little thing and then turn to their life. No, they don't, ya ikhwati fillah. So tadhakaru wallahi thumma wallahi inna nasrallahi qareeb. The nasr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's very, very near. Ikhwati fillah, what are the benefits of being tested? What is the benefit? Everywhere you see, in Palestine, I don't have to talk about. In Somalia, the Ethiopians, the Christian Ethiopians, they will drive from their homeland and they will come to the imam on the minbar and grab him and nobody can say anything to them. In Philippines, how many of you know about Filipino brothers? How many of you know? Every year, over 100,000 of them are killed. But we don't know about them. Because they're not here, we don't see them. Everywhere you go, everywhere you turn, this is what is happening. But what is the benefit of this, ya ikhwati fillah? First, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will see how true you are. We'll see if you just this Islam of yours is a lip service or you are willing to do something for this deen. It is just, oh, I wear my hijab or I just grow my beard and I come to the masjid and this is it. Or you're willing to go that extra mile. You do what it takes. The second thing, ya ikhwati fillah, this test is not bad. What is happening to this ummah is not all bad. It is takfir al-khataya. It is takfir, expiation for the sins that we commit as an ummah. I mean, don't you see this amr ilahi? Don't you see this amr rabbani? That we all feel the pain, but at the same time, we're not willing to do one little thing? It is something from above, because as an ummah, we're not thinking the same way. Also, ya ikhwati fillah, this would teach you how to put your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You tried everything. Every system that exists on the face of earth, we tried. We tried. Didn't work. So this will teach you the only one that you rely on, the only one that you trust is your Creator. No one else. Not the United Nations. Not the Arab League. Not this or that. The only one that you should trust is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one else. Also, ya ikhwati fillah, from this test you will learn who are your enemies. You will learn. There are a lot of people who are claiming that they are on our side. But the time of tests and trials, that will be filtered. And you will know who are the true enemy of Islam, ya ikhwati fillah. Also, ya ikhwati fillah, if we are going through tests, it's because that Allah still cares about us. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will only test those whom He loves subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ikhwati fillah, I will also conclude one more thing before I finish this, and that is, This test would inspire us to do and to be better. When you see your sisters being raped in Palestine, when you see our sisters being raped in Palestine and everywhere else, this dunya would mean nothing to you. And you will desire to be a better person, to improve yourself. I know I'm running out of time, but I want to say one thing, and that is, Wallahi thumma wallahi ya ikhwati fillah. Allah will never abandon this ummah. Wallahi thumma wallahi. Allah, till the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah, will take care of this deen. And that's why you have people coming to Islam every single day. And here, inshallah, I want to introduce a brother who just accepted Islam right now. Brother Lucas, yes, he wants to say the Shahada. He accepted Islam in spite of what these people are doing, in spite of what they're saying about this deen. Alhamdulillah, thumma alhamdulillah, this deen is increasing. Alhamdulillah, thumma alhamdulillah. 70% of the people who accept Islam, our sisters, in spite of what they say about Islam. Wanted to say the Shahada.
Okay.
Yes. Ashhadu.
Ashhad.
An. La.
La.
Ilaha.
Ilaha.
Illallah.
Ilallah.
Wa ashhad.
Ashhad.
An.
An.
Muhammad.
Muhammad.
Rasul.
Rasul.
Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. This is this deen. This deen, ya ikhwati fillah, if you don't do your job as a Muslim and Muslima, Allah will replace us with better people. Ya ikhwati fillah, as they say here, it's job security. You have to fight for your position in Jannah. Our brother, alhamdulillah, accepted Islam, and we hope Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring the rest of the ummah. Outside, I'm talking about the ummah, the da'wah to Islam. Jazakallah khair. Lucas, thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Allah barak fi. Salaam alaykum wa rahmatullah. And we know this is your brother. Hug him. Don't kiss him too much. It's not easy, a lot of kisses. You know, and squeeze him. And this is your family. And welcome to Islam, ya ikhwati fillah.
We have 10 minutes for questions and answers. Do you want to take some
Inshallah, the questions would be at the end of the day, inshallah, with all the shi'a.